Today I'm going to show you how to group SNOMED data using Python and a terminology server. I'm using Visual Studio Code and I've installed the Python extension. First we're going to create a new Python file. Then we'll get some imports out of the way for the methods we're going to use in this demo, from the Pathling library, the PySpark library which comes with Pathling, and also Plotly for visualization. Next, we'll create a new Pathling context, which gives us an opportunity to specify any options. Here we're saying that we want to use a local terminology cache on the disk, and we want to override the expiry that the terminology server sends back. This allows us to speed up our iterations on this analysis by not having to make the same terminology requests over and over again. Now we can load our source data from a CSV file and select the ID, arrive at, and primary diagnosis concept columns. We'll print out the schema just to make sure it looks as we would expect. And now we're going to start adding columns to this table. We've selected the ID, we've changed the date to be month only, we'll select the SNOMED concept ID for the primary type diagnosis, and then we'll go off to the terminology server and retrieve the preferred term for each of these codes. The next three columns are viral infection, musculoskeletal injury, and mental health problem. And in these columns, we're testing the membership of the code within a particular value set. For viral infection, the value set is all codes which are subsumed by the viral infection code. And same for musculoskeletal injury, all codes which are subsumed by injury of the musculoskeletal system. For mental health problem, we've actually created an ECL expression for this value set, and any codes that match this expression will return true for this function. So how do we come up with these value sets? The answer is through a combination of querying the data and querying the terminology to find what would be appropriate groupings or categorizations that fit the type of analytic use case that you're working on. You can query the terminology through SHRIMP. For example, here we're looking up the code for viral infection and having a look at the descendants of that code. If we use the subsumed by function within Pathling, it will return true if the code within our data is either exactly viral infection or any one of the descendants of viral infection. We've also used the subsumption technique for musculoskeletal injury, and if we search this in SHRIMP, you can see all of the codes which are much more specific that we can capture within our data if we use this technique. Finally, for our mental health category, we identified that simple subsumption of a single code wasn't going to be good enough to capture all the codes that we wanted. So we elected to use an ECL expression. An ECL expression allows us to describe more complex criteria for matching of codes within SNOMED. Here we're saying that we want our value set to include not just descendants or self of mental state finding, but also several other codes and their descendants. Once we've completed our expression and we're happy with the codes that it captures, we can click on the Copy ECL button to copy that expression to the clipboard, and then we can paste it into our Python script. One thing to note is that because a SNOMED concept can have multiple parents, these categories that we're creating can potentially be overlapping. One example of this is rabies coma, which is both a type of viral infection and also a type of mental health finding. We'll cover techniques for how to achieve mutually exclusive categories later in this video. Back to our Python script. The next thing we're going to do is count all of the encounters that happened during each month using the group by statement. Then we will again count the number of encounters in each month three more times, but this time filtering by the columns that we have already created for our diagnosis categorizations. So each of these tables will provide a count grouped by month, but only of the encounters that had a diagnosis that fell within that value set. Finally, we can use the toPandas function to convert the result into a pandas data frame, which we can then feed to Plotly to create some visualizations. The first thing we're going to do with Plotly is create a simple bar chart with the arrival month on the x-axis and the number of encounters on the y-axis. Then we'll create a second bar chart. This time it'll be a grouped bar chart, and each of our three categories will live together on the y-axis. And that's it. You can go to the Run menu and hit Run without debugging to run the script. This is the grouped bar chart with our categories. And this is the bar chart that shows all encounters. Now, I mentioned before that these categories may be overlapping due to the nature of SNOMED. So let's have a go at modifying this example to achieve mutually exclusive categories. This time we'll create a table with just our first category, viral infection, in it. Then when we create our column for musculoskeletal injury, we will define it as not just being the result of the subsumed by function, but we will make sure the code was also not in the viral infection set. The tilde operator in Spark indicates not. And we'll do the same for mental health. In this case, the condition will be that the code is in the mental health set of codes, and it's also not in musculoskeletal or viral infection. Finally, this time we'll create an other category, and that category will be codes that were not in any of the other categories. So what we've done here is actually create a hierarchy of categories. If a code is not in the first category, it flows onto the next category. And if it doesn't end up being in any category, it ends up in the other category. So there are some decisions to make in what is appropriate in terms of designing this hierarchy and what the appropriate order would be. Same as last time, we will use a set of group by statements to count the number of encounters within each category. The only difference being that we also count how many are in the other category. Our visualization is pretty similar, with the exception that we're using a bar mode of relative and a range of 0 to 100 to achieve the 100% bars. So these are our proportional bars based on our mutually exclusive categories. And this is our all encounters bar chart, unchanged. For more details and examples of how to use the functions within Pathling for grouping SNOMED data, check out the terminology functions section of the documentation. You can get there by clicking on libraries. And the value set membership and subsumption testing sections of that page are the relevant ones. And that's it. Thanks so much for watching. If you'd like more content about how to use Pathling, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks.